You can export parts of an image using the export persona in Affinity Photo. And that's here. Just go over here to the fifth item there, export persona. Now go to the slice tool and create a quick slice. Now I'm just going to set something like that. And you can set it in the transform. So I'm going to go for 600 by 700. Now with that set, what I can do, I can create some more. Now if you just go up there, you can see a little red dot. So it's aligned on that. And as you go down, it will indicate that it's the length. Now, the width should indicate as well. I must admit, doing test runs on this, sometimes it appears, sometimes it doesn't. It just ignores, but it should go across as well. However, you can always just quickly set it. So if you decide, you know what, you're going to go where you've got 600 by 700, I'm just going to set that to 600 and 700. So 600 and 700, and you can just do it manually. It's a pity, but it doesn't. It should indicate, but sometimes it just ignores. And again, you can do another one. So again, so I'm going to go for 600, 700. I just set it there. It's easier than waiting for the arrow to appear. But there should be an arrow across and an arrow down when you match the height and width. So you've got these now. And you can position it over certain parts of the image that you're happy with. And you could create 15, 20, 30 of these if you want. And you can overlap, you can move them around and so on. Now, once you've done that, got here over in the slices panel, you notice you've got the slices. Now you don't have to export the background, you can always deselect that. By default, it's on, so it will export it. But you've got here, these are the ones that are going to be exported. Also, what you do, you can expand out there. And you can turn around and say, well, I've got PNG, you could put it to JPEG if you prefer JPEG. But you can also go here, times. There's a times feature. So you can say, you know what? I want it to be 20 times. Now, obviously, you're going to push it too far, and maybe, but you can get some real big blow-ups of an image. So if you want, you're looking to, you've got an image, and you want, say, a massive, massive image from that, you can do it very quickly. So hopefully, it will look pretty good afterwards. So you've got 20, say 20. You can put 20 times there, and it will then make sense, it's 20 times. The 20 doesn't seem to work, it just ignores it. Just put 20x, that's 20 times, and you can see now you've got a name there. Fortunately, that's cut off, it's sort of dot, dot, dot there. But it is 20 times, and I'm gonna do the same here. So I can just go down here, and again, put 20x. Now, I haven't tried it, maybe. It could put 100x, I don't know. Have you noticed also the name, slice 2, that's the name it's gonna give it, that's the same name. You can change it. You don't have to have slice 2, slice 1. You can change it. Just click on that and then just simply put a different name. Also, you go to the third one and you can do the same. And again, make certain you put 20x and you've got 20x there. So it's 20 times the size of this. So whatever that is, 20 times 600, 20 times 700. Pretty big. So you've got that. And now what you can do, just go down to the bottom and export slices. So I'm just going to do that. And I'm going to put it to a folder called test and export. Now, obviously it's going to take a few seconds and it's going to take longer when it's bigger files. Obviously 20 times, it's going to be a lot more processing. It's not going to be instantaneous. If it's just one times, it's pretty instantaneous, but it's not instantaneous if it's 20 times. I mean, that's quite a fairly large file size of PNG anyway. You can see it's just processing it. And so there's various other formats. You could go for SVG, PSDs, TIFFs, etc. Weirdly, I don't think there's the AF photo format, which is a weird oversight if that's the case. However, let's just go to there and you can see now you've got these files and you can see they're quite large there, 25.7 megs. Obviously that original one was nowhere near that size. And you can see now if I go there, open with, and I'm just going to open with preview. And there it is. So it's 20 times that size. So it's quite a large file. And to be honest, I think the image still looks pretty decent. Not too bad. And of course, this could be done with photos, text, etc., as well as shapes and much, much, much more. I'll just close that. Hope you found this of interest. Thank you much.